It's official. CBS, take my money. We're going to talk about the new trailer for Star Trek Picard, which is something we were very concerned about. We won't talk that much about that show that shall not be named,
Discovery Earth.
But we will briefly talk about, I'll briefly just tell you that I love every Star Trek series there is ever, except for, of course, STD or Discovery or whatever it's called. Obviously, there are a couple awesome things about Discovery, but most of it is awful. So let's just talk about Star Trek Picard. Something that we were really concerned about, I was concerned about, everybody who had a brain would be concerned about. Now, if you're somebody naive or, you know, ignorance is bliss, then maybe you weren't concerned about this whatsoever. But anybody who had been paying attention to the way Paramount, Star Trek, and the whole deal with CBS had been performing and how they have to keep certain things different, then you would have been very, very concerned. Now, this trailer has, this has given us even more than I believed we would get. With Jonathan Frakes directing episodes, to Jeri Ryan returning as Seven of Nine, to whether it's Picard talking to Data, who's been reassembled and brought back through the memory of B4, or whether this is Picard talking to B4, or whether this is Picard talking to a hologram or a holodeck version of Data. We don't know, but either way, all of these little cameos in a trailer that I've seen a couple times now. This trailer is, I think, a very good trailer. I can't believe it. I was really, really concerned about this show. You know, a lot of the character variations and things kind of give me that little bit of a vibe of Deep Space Nine a little bit. But there was nothing really that made me say, oh no, here comes the social justice warrior stuff and the agenda stuff. Now that could be in here. Hopefully it's not. But there wasn't anything in the trailer that triggered me into that. Certainly was a lot of female representation, which is something that's going on, but it seemed like it was equal with a lot of stuff in this trailer. So let's take a look at it, and we'll talk a little bit about this trailer here.
Have you ever been a stranger to yourself?
And hopefully CBS is not taking content down of people who are reviewing this trailer, because it's friggin' awesome. I am Star Trek fan since 1987, so don't take it down. We like the show so far. We like the trailer so far, amazingly. And, you know, we got a little concerned when Patrick Stewart said, you know, this Picard will be a different Picard than you remember. And it was like, oh no, it's going to be like really crazy. But he really doesn't seem like that. He does seem like a lot's happened, but it very much feels like Picard, like an older Picard who's a little bit lost of, you know, how he's unsure how to, you know, retire. And like you said, he's in the trailer having he doesn't really feel like he's at home where he's been at the vineyard and everything, where you thought he would grow old and retire and stay.
Many, many times. Nearly two decades ago, Commander Data sacrificed his life for me. These past few years, I really tried to belong here. But it never truly felt like home.
Do you know who I am? Everything inside of me says that I'm safe with you.
Admiral, I have been...
You can see here that the, and I'm assuming you guys have watched the trailer full already, so I'm going to be pausing it. He's kind of got this almost casual black or dark or gray black Starfleet jacket on, it looks like here. Maybe that's like a retirement jacket or something. And you see the classic uniforms over here, or like the newer version, like the version from Deep Space Nine, a little bit altered slightly, but you would expect that because you would expect new uniforms, you know, 20 years later. So they're very close, though, to the original TNG. The badge is a little bit different. More looks like the badge that we saw, or the communicator that we saw in, like, All Good Things at the end, because obviously the future, you know, they'd maybe want to stick to that. So it's more of a, it's more bulky, maybe. You know, I'm not really sure. So that's really good news there that we're seeing these sort of the classic uniforms. Yeah, I mean, so far I like everything looks right. You know, it really does. It looks right.
Counted a woman.
So that's the Admiral. So the Admiral's, she's kind of dressed in a weird, in a different way too, because she's kind of got this gray outfit on as well. Like, just like Bob Picard was wearing when he walked up, he's got that gray jacket. So it's almost like, you know, I can see her rank over here, and I can see the red, the very maroon, dark maroon underneath the dark gray. I like this uniform. It's almost, but I don't know. I like it though. I like the uniform. It's almost like we're seeing, it's funny because we're like kind of seeing the TNG era. It reminds you of the TNG era a little bit, like some of the look here and the design and the what's going on, but it's also a little bit more, even more upgraded to today's standards, I guess. But it's not. It's so simple too. Look at this, which is what we always thought. You know, I always thought the future would be look better, simple, with technology integrated into it, rather than just insane technology and lights everywhere and crazy. Like, it just doesn't seem like that's the future. Something Back to the Future 2 got right. If you remember, like, you know, futuristic shows about 2020, right? In 2020, there would just be beaming lights everywhere and buildings everywhere and flying cars everywhere and smog, and it would look crazy. But Back to the Future 2, it was like, no, it looks like now, but like with some different technologies. That's way more realistic. And I think even as far in the future as we are here, it's still pretty realistic. But, you know, that's just my opinion on that.
A woman, she came to me for help. If she is who I think she is, she's in serious danger.
Sometimes I worry that you've forgotten who you are.
Now, Leah thinks that's Troy speaking right there, but then they cut to a different woman speaking, and she sounds very similar, but that could be a trick. Let's listen.
Who you are.
I think that's a different woman, but Leah thinks that's Troy. However, Troy is apparently going to be in this show somewhere at some point.
We do not.
You can't do it alone. You need help. You need protection. You need a crew. Be the captain they remember. She truly is.
She's the end of all. She's the destroyer.
The hell are you doing out here, Picard?
So, the Borg. Well, obviously, we get like, it looks like we're getting the Borg cube here. And, you know, the guy who played Hugh, the Borg that they named in TNG back in the day, that they named, I guess that actor was on stage with them during the Comic-Con or whatever. So there's something going on there and the Borg cube. That's interesting. There's obviously seemingly something going on with the Romulans. We've seen Romulans a few times. This guy laying on the ground in a few minutes, he's Romulan. So it's very interesting. I don't know what's going on there. I believe there's 10 episodes.
She truly is.
She's the end of all.
There's the Romulan.
She's the destroyer.
The question is Romulus destroyed because of the canon of the Star Trek comic books that came out during the J.J. Abrams movies? Is Romulus actually destroyed? Because it should be canon that it was destroyed, and everything after that is non-canon. I don't know. That's going to be a big thing here, we find out. Or is this a third timeline, as it's been said to be, a third timeline from the original timeline and the other timeline? And so everything here could even be different as well, which is just confusing, and I don't even want to get into it, but apparently that's what I thought it was. So is Romulus destroyed? That's a huge question. And if it was, then Data was alive during those comics. So are those comic books being retconned, or they do not exist here, or are they not canon? I guess I'll have to do some more digging on that information, and then this show's going to tell us, perhaps.
What the hell are you doing out here, Picard? Saving the galaxy?
Engage. I don't want the game to end.
I can see that, Captain.
Oh, you know people pop for that. I gotta tell you, man. I can't even pull myself together right now. I got that trailer. I mean, like, I thought I was gonna kind of like the trailer. You know, I thought it was gonna be pretty good. Perhaps because they realized all the mistakes they've made, and going back to Picard, I thought, I was like, you know, it could be good, man. It could be all right. And at the same time, I don't know, but I'm just dying for anything TNG. We've been dying for TNG since 2003. And the last time we really got a sample of TNG was actually, I guess, 2004 or so, when they did that flashback episode on Star Trek Enterprise. And so getting this, and then seeing this sort of whatever new story they're trying to tell here, mixed in here with Picard and some of the other stuff, and people mentioning Seven of Nine, wow, she just seems really human now. Well, I mean, 20 years have passed, so she's probably going to get more and more human, right, as the years go on. So that doesn't bother me whatsoever. I think that that's actually pretty accurate. That's how I always thought it would be. Or getting kind of her humanity back and her personal side back, I always thought would happen with Seven and Nine. But I can't even tell you how excited I think that this has made me. I think a lot of people are going to sign up. I think CBS has a hit with this trailer. I think a lot of people are going to sign up for CBS Access because of this trailer. This is amazingly good news for them right now. Star Trek Discovery was so bad, you know, just the interest of Star Trek, people signed up, and then I would say about half of those people can still defend that show. But I'll tell you what, if Star Trek Discovery gets more seasons than Star Trek Enterprise did, that would be a true travesty, a just despicable, disgusting, like, sort of thing that I just can't wrap my head around. But Star Trek Picard looks good, at least right now. You know, it really does. I think that this could definitely make their app explode. But, you know, I'm also hoping, unfortunately, though, one of the things that bums me out is, let's say this is great. Let's say the show is awesome or it's really good. One thing that will bother me is I will wish that I could watch it on, like, a Blu-ray collection. And I don't think they'll ever release that, probably, because they want you to stay signed up to access. So it may be years before you see a Blu-ray collection of some sort. And, you know, one of the other things is, of course, these are going to be all, like, you know, serialized. There'll be a long story arc that's told. I think it's going to work in this case. And I think one of the reasons why it works with Picard is because, you know, we don't know how long Picard can be around. We don't know how long Patrick Stewart can play this character. So if they were to launch a new series with Picard there, it would have been tougher, I believe. But maybe at the end of this, he becomes an admiral. Maybe the end of this show, he becomes an admiral. And then the new cast that he's with, some of the new cast he's with, goes on to be a new show. And then maybe Picard, from time to time, stops by, makes an appearance as an admiral. That would be, in my opinion, the best thing that could happen. I think that would be the best way to go about it, you know? But, of course, seeing Data or B4 or seeing a hologram of Data, whatever this is, the trailer was really, really exciting and good, and it got people, right, everybody I talked to who said, that's going to be garbage. They've ruined everything. And I'm not saying I didn't agree with that, because I thought, oh man, I'm worried. I'm really worried about this. But I am way less worried right now. That's my initial thoughts. I hope you subscribe down below. Leave your comments down below with what you think about Star Trek. I'm going to have way more comments on this later as I watch more, read more, and figure out what's going on here. And I get some other opinions, and then I start brainstorming in my own head. I'll have more opinions on this later. But right now, visually, I like it, and it looks like it could be pretty good. Leave a like or a comment down below, and I'll read your comments, and I'll probably respond to those in the next video.